Hi there, this is Ranjit, and in this video we'll be doing the full camera review for this OPPO Reno 2Z. And if you guys recall, in my unboxing video I said that the camera on this one actually impressed me, and it got a new update. So let's check out the camera performance on this one. And this one is actually having a quad camera setup. As you can see, it has that four cameras over here, and the main camera is actually a 48 megapixel on this one. Then we also have a 8 megapixel that's wide angle. Then we have a 2 megapixel that's a monochrome, and I think so this is helping this device. And then we again have a 2 megapixel that's for depth. The front facing camera is actually a pop-up on this, as you can see. If you just it just pops up like this. So that's the physical overview, but again, that's the half the picture. Let's see how it actually takes the picture. So I've taken a ton of pictures and even videos, but before that, let me actually show you the interface, because this one has some additional features. And as you can see over here, this is the standard. You have that 1x and 2x option, but guys, this is a digital zoom, so I would say go only till this is in the photo mode. 1x, 2x and 5x it can go, but I would say don't go over 2x. And then we also have the regular portrait, and I forgot, if you click this button, it goes into the wide angle mode, and you can even shoot videos in the wide angle. I'll show you the samples, but this is regular over here. And then we also have the portrait mode, and in the video mode, again, it shoots video fine, up to 4k you can shoot, but we also have this mode, and you can shoot in ultra wide. And but apart from that, you also have this button. This is known as the ultra steady mode that we have. So we have quite a few modes on this one. And front facing also, again, the regular, what do you say, video option we have. We have photo and even portrait. I've disabled all the beauty modes, but you can enable it. So let's do one thing. Let's look at the actual samples and see how it performs. So here are the sample shot with the Reno 2Z. And if you notice, the colors are very natural, unlike some smartphones that try to boost the colors and saturate it. Here, the colors are very natural. It was a very cloudy and overcast day, and this is reflected, and this was taken in the wide angle lens. To give you one more idea, this was taken in the regular lens, and this was actually shot in that wide angle lens. Even in the wide angle lens, I feel it's protecting the colors. Now moving to human subjects, this was taken in the regular mode, and as you can see, the skin tone colors are produced very well. This was using the portrait bokeh mode on the same, and this was with the wide angle lens. I like the fact that colors are not getting weird in the wide angle lens. One more example, this was the regular shot. Again, see the details, and this was taken in the portrait mode, and this was finally in that wide angle lens. One more regular shot, and this was taken in the portrait mode. I also had the Vivo V17 Pro with me, and they are priced very similar, so decided to take some samples side by side. And as you can see, this was the regular shot, and definitely in this one, the Reno is having more detail, much brighter picture. Notice this is the bokeh portrait mode. I don't know about you, but I like the picture on the Reno 2Z. Notice my face on the Vivo V17 Pro, it made it very dark. And these again sample side by side. I noticed the Vivo tries to brighten up the picture quite a bit. As you can see, it was a very overcast day, and the Reno 2Z actually produced the realistic results. Also, I noticed that the Vivo tends to oversaturate the pictures, as it's evident from this picture. Now moving to the front facing camera, these were with the Reno, and as you can see, it did a good job. This was taken in the portrait bokeh mode, and again, to give you an idea, this was taken in the regular mode. The pictures are very sharp, and this was taken in the portrait bokeh mode. One more picture in the portrait bokeh mode. Also decided to compare side by side, because Vivo is a front facing camera king, and but it has that wide angle lens, which is simply not present on the Reno. And here I enabled the portrait bokeh mode in both these devices. Again, the Reno actually did pretty well with the front facing camera, but Vivo is certainly more versatile because it has that dual front facing camera. So these were taken in semi-indoor conditions, and now moving to completely artificial lighting conditions also. As you can see, this Reno 2Z actually did a pretty good job. As you can see, these were taken in my office in completely artificial lighting. Then also, as you can see, we have actually quite a bit of detail. Now moving to human subjects, again in completely artificial lighting, this was that portrait bokeh mode, and this was with that wide angle lens. Again, as you can see, it actually did a pretty good job even in artificial lighting in the various mode. For example, this was portrait, this is that wide angle lens. And now moving to the front facing camera, again, the front facing camera performance was also actually really good, as you can see with these sample shots. Shooting this video with the OPPO Reno 2Z, and
As you can see, guys, I'm just walking handheld. It's supposed to stabilize the video. On this preview, it looks like it's stabilized even though I'm walking. But you guys, let me know what you feel about the video with this OPPO Reno 2Z. And it can record up to 4K, but this here I have set it to actually 1080p. Again, shooting the video, and as you can see, this is in the wide angle mode. And you can also shoot the video in the wide angle mode with this Reno 2Z. And this should actually give you an idea how is the video recording with this ultra wide mode. And I really like when manufacturers allow us to record video even in this wide angle mode. It gives a very different perspective, as you can see. Now, shooting this video with the front facing camera, and also you can have the beauty option in the front facing camera. I have disabled that, and as you can see, I'm just walking around, so that this should give you an idea how is the video recording with the front facing camera of this OPPO Reno 2Z. Now, shooting the video, we also have this ultra steady mode, so I'm recording in that. Let's see what it does, because even in the regular mode it was very steady, but here, as you can see, I'm just walking like a maniac here. Let me just run also. I'm actually running. So here in the preview, it looks like it's on a gimbal. But let me know what do you think about the same. Let me just go back again. Yes, it looks pretty steady. But you guys, let me know. So guys, testing this new feature that this OPPO has, that is known as live video blur. As you can see, we are shooting a video, but the background is blurred. So again, this is a new feature, and you can actually adjust the amount of blur that you want in the video. So again, this is actually a pretty cool feature found on the OPPO.
So guys, as you saw with the camera samples, the camera performance is actually surprisingly good. There are a lot of smartphones these days with that 48 megapixel rear facing camera, but I feel this one is doing a very good job. As you saw with the samples, the colors actually look very natural, and even for human subjects where skin tones are very important, I feel it produced very accurate skin tones. Because generally what I've seen is with many phones with the skin tones, particularly in the portrait mode and stuff, it makes your face very dark and stuff, so it's not pleasing. But here we got very consistent results even with skin tones and other stuff. I just saw the pictures were very, very natural. And I think so that 2 megapixel monochrome lens that it has, it aids. And also I feel that it has this new Helio P90 SoC that is also helping this one to take those pictures. As you saw, the pictures came out really good. And I think so that chip is also helping it quite a bit, because that chip is heavily focused on AI and on the camera department. What do you think about this one? I also like the fact that the video performance was very good. That ultra steady mode is actually pretty cool. If you are in an area where it's very uneven and you're shooting a video, I would say enable that and you get some very good results. So certainly a very good smartphone. I would say camera is the trump card of this one. But you saw the samples. What do you think about the camera performance of this OPPO Reno 2Z? Anyways, guys, that's it for now. Thanks for watching. This is Ranjit, and I hope to see you in my next video. Again, you want to know more about this one? Watch the unboxing video that I had posted earlier. Anyways, guys, that's it for now. Catch you later.